Mikey Sherrill and Jay Weber come to this election from very different paths. He's been a conservative state lawmaker for a decade. She's a former lieutenant commander and Navy helicopter pilot. He's raised just over $1 million for his campaign, modest by today's standards. She has raised at least seven times that amount and has Democrats across the country calling her a political rock star in the making.
Nobody's a rock star yet. I mean, she's good. She's a great campaigner. She raised bucketfuls of money, but it's too early to... We love doing that with our politicians. They're going to be governor someday. They're going to be Speaker of the House someday. We don't, you know, nobody knows.
You could argue that Weber, with perhaps the most established conservative bona fides in the state, is a Republican rock star in the making. As impressive a physical presence as Sherrill, with a Harvard law degree to match hers from Georgetown. Early on, he kept his distance from the ruling Republicans, but down the stretch, he's embraced the party and the president.
The human impact of this tax cut is felt across New Jersey and across this country. People are more secure in their jobs. They want a small business. They have the ability and confidence to go forward in this economy and start a small business. The arrow is pointing up in this country, and it's in large part due to that tax cut. We should be celebrating it, not looking for the dark lining and the silver cloud that America is enjoying.
Sherrill has disputed that sunny assessment and called Weber out for being a Trump Republican. But when given the opportunity to trash Trump directly, she's mostly taken a pass.
Now, why not take a stronger stand against the president's policies towards women?
You know, I have taken a strong stand against his policies towards women, and in fact have expressed my concerns about his policy towards women, I think in about the strongest way I can express them in running for Congress.
But this is a traditionally Republican district. Rodney Frelinghuysen's had it for 22 years, and there are a lot more Republicans and Democrats here, and I think some of them are starting to come home, and I think that's why it's tightening.
In both these races, turnout is key, and the rain doesn't help either side, really, because even in a critical midterm, folks can sometimes opt to stay dry and at home and just watch what happens on TV, which makes today an even tougher day for campaign workers.